Nous savons tous ce qu'est un projet.
We all know what a project
Nous
is.
Avons tous des projets de vie.
We all have projects in our life,
maisons, voire même de
trips,
recherche.
Houses,
Il s'agit toujours
even
d'une
research.
Projection dans le futur.
A project is always about making a projection in the future, building something, something tangible that we want to achieve. A project is never a turnkey element. A project needs to be built. And this is a process that will change, turn an idea into a reality. So it takes time. You have to find information, sometimes find material, ask help from specialists, and the time spent allows the idea to be refined and even possibly reoriented. So the stages will participate in the will to meet the final objective. Giving up a project is very often felt to be a failure. In the project, there is something intrinsical, intimate. What about the same idea being used for teaching purposes? The project may be initiated by the teacher, but it can't be imposed. Participating in the elaboration, defining the stages, the very important elements are part of the motivation that the pupils may or may not show for the project. On the Geneva University website for students, it says that a project is a teaching method with a finality and teaching objective, and it regards the things that are built by the pupils. In school, teaching is inspired by different projects, the father of which is Prenet and his printing equipment. Nowadays, a newspaper or a newsletter may be a project, but we can also have exhibitions for the pupils or for the parents, photovoltaic panels being placed on the roof, a vegetable garden or a competition, or making cakes in order to raise funds to fund a given type of activity, a final product that will require participation from the whole class. Therefore, a project must meet four characteristics. Everyone should be involved in the process, everyone should participate in the choices and the implementation. Therefore, a project is interdisciplinary because it must lead to a concrete achievement within a given period of time. Now, this is important because not only should the pupils be proud that they can deliver a finished product, but also they should be able to manage the time, and this requires skills. For instance, anticipation, the time, the resources, the various stages that the project must go through. Also, we have to select the relevant elements, knowledge, information, the size of the project, because sometimes people will be carried away by enthusiasm and will not focus sufficiently. And finally, there is also the capacity to set hierarchies based on very accurate criteria, scientific criteria if one is looking for information, or the importance of some actions and the urgency with which this or that stage must be completed. In order to help with anticipation, a conceptual map may be prepared with the pupils, and this is a very relevant management tool because it helps pupils manage anticipation and understand when to look for resources and help. In order to make a vegetable garden, it might be necessary to request authorization from the township, find tools, gardening tools, acquire knowledge on which vegetables can be grown and at what time, get help from an experienced gardener, find money to buy seeds, and also organize a calendar in order to maintain the garden and anticipate on the crops. Once this has been done, chores can be listed and distributed, and this will teach pupils about discipline. Some people may have to write letters. This will require some schools or look for documents, because that means you have to be able to use a computer, or possibly relations with the neighbors in order to get them to lend tools. Funding can be acquired by making cakes, and therefore this requires cooking skills, and preparing a plan and a calendar will require collaboration from all those who will participate in the development of a collective form of intelligence. Now, pupils must understand that not everybody must participate in all the stages. It is useful to differentiate and adjust the objectives on the pupils' competences or those they need to acquire. In summary, what are the advantages of projects used as a teaching tool? Projects will place students in situations that will not be cleared without learning new skills. And because you need to have good grammar and spelling if you want to write a letter to get authorization to make a garden, will push the pupils to improve their skills in this discipline. The same goes for biological knowledge or knowledge in history or geography. Very quickly, the students will understand that the more intelligent, and that collaboration will increase efficacy. And also, the involved students will not easily accept that the others will not do their job correctly, because that would make the whole project weaker. A project has concrete final aims, and therefore it means that it also involves skills that are not necessarily school skills. And children who have trouble adapting to school methods might become more self-confident. So this is a way to implement differentiated teaching methods. And finally, if we consider the entrepreneurship of a project will help children understand what it means to design a project and implement a project as in real life. So what connection is there between project as a teaching tool and education for sustainable development? As Mérieux says, a project means that the pupil must become active and actor, which means that he is going to develop as a future citizen who is capable of caring for himself and affirming his freedom. And beyond the program of the project itself, it moves and uses transversal competences, which are more than the fact of knowing how to be. Therefore, these are the competences listed by Majou and Monet, but there is more to it, because we have elements here that have to do with collective knowledge, and there are also contributions made by systemic sciences. For instance, the complexity which is needed to implement a project. As Mérieux said, there are aspects pertaining to ethics and responsibility and the development of a constructive and critical mind. Finally, prospective and change are also something that will depend from the project itself.